This week's player in profile on Fever TV has been a standout for us in the first few weeks of the ANZ Championship, with her versatility proving invaluable in the opening few rounds. I speak, of course, of shooter come wing attack Kate Beveridge. KB, what a start to the year for yourself.
Yeah, it's been an enjoyable year for Fever with three wins on the run. Unfortunately, one loss, but it's been exciting for me as well getting out on court. Which has been really enjoyable and also quite relaxing at wing attack, not having to worry about the shooting, which has been pretty good.
Plenty of people were surprised, not so much yourself though. Stace has spent a bit of time on working on your feeds into the circle, and she mentioned that that was one of the big keys behind throwing you out there, is how impressed she's been with your work over the off-season.
Yeah, and I think having a shooting background makes it easier because I know where I'd like the ball. To this date I've only gone up against the taller wing defence, so it will be interesting to see whether that continues or whether I can perhaps try and match it against those smaller ones. But so yeah, it'll be interesting to see where it goes.
What have you enjoyed most about the new challenge so far this year?
Definitely not having to shoot. There's less pressure. No offence to wing attacks and centre quarters, because I know how hard it is. But yeah, when you've got, the two best shooters in the world, you pass it to them, that they're going to get it in. So it's been really relaxing, I guess.
You mentioned that loss on the weekend. We did learn plenty of lessons, but certainly plenty of positives as well to take out of that game. And good to have that sort of experience early in the season.
Yeah, I think Swiss will walk away with the win, but as long as we let them walk away with only that and we learn from it and grow from it. And I think we've done that certainly already with our review and our training session this morning. So I think it will be probably a great step for us having that loss early on and being able to fix those little things.
And we look ahead now to a pretty difficult road trip. We have back-to-back games in New Zealand. Do you enjoy road trips? Do you see them as much as a challenge as what they're made out to be?
Yeah, I love them. I can't wait to get away. One, because I don't have to work as much, which is really nice. Probably not what my employers want to hear. But I really love it. I find it much more relaxing. You go away, you do your thing. You don't have to do all those weekly duties that you would normally have to do away. So I find it really relaxing, and you can really just focus on your netball whilst you're away.
KB, been here in Perth and at the Fever now for a little while. Of course, spent time both the Thunderbirds and the Vixens beforehand. So you've seen plenty of different teams and experienced plenty of different cultures. What do you enjoy most about, I suppose, the new look Fever under Stacey Rossman in her second year?
Yeah, so this is my fourth year at Fever, and I think now we're really getting the relationship right between, coaching and flexibility with work, which is certainly, I think, really paid advantage to myself being a worker as well. So I think that's, people are more relaxed, they're doing really well, we're winning, that really helps. But I think, the winning is a lot to do with what's been happening at training, what's been happening off court through what Stacey has brought to the party, which has been really exciting.
You mentioned your work. You do an incredible amount both on court with us, but you have your off court commitments with the Ladder organisation, which for those unfamiliar, it must be an incredibly rewarding job. Tell people who might not know much about Ladder what it is exactly that you do.
Yeah, so our organisation Ladder is, I guess tagline is tackling youth homelessness. So working with those youth who are at risk of homelessness or are homeless, and trying to enable them to live the life that they deserve and the life that they're capable of. So I love it. I'm one of those lucky people who love both jobs that I do and enjoy going to work every day. So it's really, I guess a really nice position to be in.
And I suppose probably pretty valuable from the point of view, it's a high pressure environment that we play in here, but provides a lot of perspective.
Oh, absolutely. You walk away from, a day at work and you realise how fortunate you are to go home to, not just a roof over your head, but that family support, I think, really shines through. And, coming from a household where my mum and dad and my brother are so supportive of me just in every way, whether it be netball or work or me as a person, just to see that people don't get that, it can be quite shocking and really sort of gives you that reality check that we need.
Staying off court, you mentioned to us in the pre-season that you do speak another language. Now, from what you've told me, you're telling a little bit of a fib, but I understand you're on the verge of learning a new language, and a pretty interesting one at that.
Yeah, so I'm looking to start learning Auslan, which is sign language, because I'm really interested in, helping those who perhaps don't get the same opportunities as a lot of us. And so I'd love to start doing some coaching with sign language to enable those non-hearing youngsters out there the ability, to stay in touch with netball, but also to get, some coaches from Fever that they wouldn't ordinarily get that opportunity to. So, yeah, I'm really looking forward to starting that in term two.
And just finally, KB, you're alter ego, White Honey. Yeah. I want to talk about that because it's referred to often on social media by a lot of your teammates, but it's something maybe the fans don't know too much about. So tell us a little bit about White Honey.
Yeah, I think Andrea Gilmore came up with it just by accident at a coffee catch-up one day. But it was just pretty organic. And so I'm White Honey, Edna is Ice Chocolate, and we sort of, the two of us took it from there. Last year we had a bit of fun with it in terms of releasing an album and stuff. And Verity, I think, would be a great little add to us, and perhaps we could come a trio because she's, you know, pretty gangster, as are Edna and I. But yeah, it's just a little bit of fun, I guess, alter ego when you want to muck around and be a little bit silly.
So we could be on the verge of a Fever but harder version of Destiny's Child.
Oh yeah, and you know, a little bit more old school hip hop, a little bit of R&B in there. Think, you know, early 90s, baggy pants, like cornrows, that's us.
Plenty to work on by the sounds of it for you guys off the court over in New Zealand. KB, really appreciate your time with us on Fever TV, and look forward to seeing you out on court in the next couple of weeks.
Thank you very much.